obviously good data coming out with adding anti-angiogenesis or chemotherapy. We'll see where the winner is with the addition of these agents to TKI. But we had some novel drugs that have been presented as well, some novel EGFR-directed therapies. One of them was TAC788, yeah, specifically looking at EGFR exon 20. Mutations. Ross, you want to talk briefly about that data?
Yeah, so EGFR exon 20s are the rarer EGFR mutations. Maybe there are somewhere between 5 and 10% of EGFR mutations, and they are traditionally not sensitive to most of the drugs that we currently have. There's one exception, FQEA, but that's actually pretty rare. But TAC788 was at least a rationally designed drug. It was trying to work in exon 20s, and the challenge is to inhibit exon 20 insertions without hitting the wild-type form of the EGFR too much. Poziotinib hits the wild-type form more than it hits exon 20. TAC788 is just about reversed. And what we saw today, a larger data set, probably about a 40% response rate, and at their recommended dose, which is 160 milligrams, the dose reduction rate was only about 25%. So it's still not free from toxicity, but it's a lot better than we've seen before, and I think it definitely is looking like one to watch.
And maybe a welcome change from the toxicity that we have seen from poziotinib, as you've highlighted. I mean, this drug seems to be as active, if not more, with much better toxicities. So we'll have to see how it all plays out. Josh, you were a senior author on another abstract, 9009, looking at JNJ372, a bispecific antibody. You want to walk us through that data? And that also had some patients that were exon 20 as well.
Yeah, right. So this was a bispecific antibody that targets both EGFR and MET. MET is known to be a mechanism of resistance to EGFR-directed therapy. And so this is an infusional therapy. And outcome results were pretty good. The overall response rate was about 30%, and that was seen in exon 20. It was actually pretty consistent. The response rate was 30% in exon 20. It was 30% overall. And it was. We also saw responses post-osimertinib, and that was regardless of the mechanism of resistance. So the toxicity of the drug is sort of interesting. There's not a lot of rash or diarrhea. The first day of infusion, very frequently patients have an infusion reaction. It has not been dangerous for any persons. It can be dramatic, but that goes away on all subsequent infusions. And so the way it was administered on the trial is there's a day one where we would give a very small amount of the drug, and you give pretreatment, and if they have an infusion reaction, you stop, you come back the next day, and you finish the dose. And then after that, it's once a week for 4 weeks, and then it's every other week. Toxicity beyond that was actually pretty good. And the response rates have been pretty impressive. The factor which was brought up at the oral presentation is trying to identify who the patients are who really benefit is really unanswered. It doesn't seem to be limited to patients who have MET amplification, and so it's unclear exactly who benefits most. Yeah.
Where's this drug going? Is it going in a post-OC space? Is it going in the treatment-naive space? Is it going just for exon 20? Do we know?
I think that there's a lot of paths forward for this drug. There is a cohort that is opened in Korea right now, which is combining JNJ372 with lazertinib, which is a third-generation tyrosine kinase inhibitor, because in the preclinical data for JNJ372, when they combined 372 with osimertinib, they saw remarkable responses, much more so than would be seen for either osimertinib or 372. So there could be some real synergy there. It's being developed along with lazertinib, which is another Janssen compound, but that's sort of where things are for that right now. But I think exploration in the exon 20 space is a real area of interest because, as we've discussed, many of the other drugs in this space are quite toxic, and this one is much less so.
Can I ask Josh a couple of questions on that one? Because I didn't get a chance to ask Eric in the presentation.
Absolutely.
So there were two things that I felt weren't shown in the presentation. One, this is supposed to work against MET. I don't care about MET amplification. Is there MET protein? Is that a relevant fact? You didn't stain for MET IHC.
So one of the issues, and you actually wrote an excellent editorial on this recently. It was really good.
Was Bob
I really
a co-author?
No, it wasn't.
No, it was bad.
Yeah,
no, it was really, really good. But the issue is that Measurement of MET is highly problematic. Figuring out what MET level we care about. Is it IHC? Is it overexpression? Is it amplification? And on this study, the way they were looking for MET, reference to what you were saying before, was on ctDNA amplification in terms of classification. And in the first part of the study, there were not required pretreatment biopsies. So now that we're getting into the second stage, all patients have pretreatment biopsies, and we will be staining for MET. But on the first part, not everyone had a sample to do that with.
So here's my second question.
I'm ready.
We got a response rate. What was the duration of response? Mm-hmm. I saw a spider plot for the exon 20s. I didn't see it for the main cohort.
So I don't know that I believe that the patients who I've seen who have responded have had responses that are similar to what we've seen with TKIs. So it's somewhere on the order of 9 months or so. But I don't believe that it's been formally measured or a median has been reported. But the patients who I've seen on this drug who have responded have responded. And it's been just like any other EGFR therapy. I have found that the rash on this drug is better than most TKIs. Maybe it's similar on the level to what we see with osimertinib. Yeah.
Who would have thought 3 years ago having all these novel therapies specifically for exon 20, the J&J drug, high dose OC, and then TAK-788, all options for our patients. Yeah. And this is an unmet need. These patients need good drugs that hopefully can outperform chemotherapy or even after chemotherapy.